My name is Wale Akinfaderin. People call me Wale, and I'm a graduate research assistant at the National High Magnetic Field Laboratory here in Tallahassee. So I came here with a soccer ball, and this soccer ball actually signifies a lot of moments in my life. It actually signifies when I actually started appreciating physics and science. I grew up in Lagos, Nigeria, in a city that has about 20 million people. So I grew up in the suburban part of the city. So right from when I was, I think, 4 years old or 5 years old, I started playing soccer on the street. So every day of my life, I play soccer. Even when I go to school, I have soccer balls in my school bag. And I play soccer. I watch soccer every day. I learned most of the tricks in soccer. Maybe how do you kick a ball? How do you, if you're a goalkeeper, how do you jump so fast? How do you have this certain reflexes, you know, to catch, you know, a soccer ball? You know, how do you dribble? How do you spin the ball? And from there, I started thinking about these things, but I don't know, you know, what answers to give. I watch a lot of, you know, some of the profound soccer players do these skills, and I assume that, okay, maybe it's magic. Maybe they're just better than everybody. Then I got into high school and I started taking physics classes. I went into this, we have sciences option, and I started taking physics classes. And from there, I started learning about some of the basics, some of the fundamental laws of physics. You know, like in the Newton's law of motion, for example, or let's say the conservation of momentum. How do you kick a ball? How do you generate enough energy, you know, to actually move towards the ball and kick it such that it goes faster, you know, than if you stay beside the ball, it won't go as fast as you'd like. There was a soccer game between France and Brazil. This was in June 1997. It was a preparation for the World Cup in 98. And a Brazilian player, Roberto Carlos, actually scored a goal. And the goal was a banana kick. He used his left foot, and he used the inside of his, the outside of his left foot to actually call the ball, and it went like a banana. So when I got into, I think it was after high school, I was preparing to write the college entrance exam, and I was going to physics class. And that was when I actually learned about something called the Magnus effect. That why is it that when you play a ball, it actually goes like a banana kick? Then I knew it wasn't magic. It's actually physics. And so what happens is that what Roberto Carlos did was that, and what a lot of players do nowadays was that they try to put a spin in the ball. So they spin the ball and they spin it out. It actually goes around, I think it's about 10 revs per second or more than that. So when they spin the ball, and because he's using his left, the outside of his left, and he actually spins it, so he goes and the ball spins in an anti-clockwise manner. So as it spins, it's actually going in a certain direction, but there's airflow that actually opposes it. So this airflow is coming back, but as it spins, there's a little air drag around the soccer ball. And because of that, because as the air drag goes anti-clockwise, you can see that it's on the right side, it actually opposes the incoming airflow, but on the right side it does not. So as it opposes the incoming airflow, there's a build-up, you know, of air, you know, around on the right side. And now, and also it actually causes pressure to actually build up. And from that, it actually deflects the ball to the right. And that's the basics of the banana ball. So then I noticed that, you know, I came to a final conclusion that everything, you know, anything that happens in soccer, in sports, for example, it's actually not magic. There's a physical phenomenon that explains it. And that has really made me grow as a scientist.